Welcome back, students. Let us continue further. So this way, as Sahu Maharaj was very well aware of the Mughal politics and their finer points, finer means smallest points, okay, that what are the policies they are framing, then who people are, you know, in the Mughals doing what plans and everything. He had observed all these things very closely when he was staying there in the Mughal camps. He knew the strengths and weaknesses of the Mughal Empire very well. So he was very well aware of their strong points, of their weak points, what are their weaker sections, everything he was very well knowing. Also, he was acquainted with the influential people in the Mughal court. Also, Sahu Maharaj had some people of the Mughals, okay? Of the Mughals, he had some people which were influenced by his side. And they were in the Mughal court, they were working in the Mughal court, but they were influenced by Sahu Maharaj and they were helping Sahu Maharaj in their work. So there were some influential people in the Mughal court. All these factors help him deciding the new direction of Maratha politics in the changing circumstances. So all these factors means which? That he was knowing the finer points of Mughal, their strength, their weaknesses, and there were some influential people. They were belonging to Mughal Empire, but still they were helping Sahu Maharaj. So he had connection with some Mughal people and they were ready to work for him. So using all these factors, he decided that he will bring the new direction in the Maratha politics in the changing circumstances. Aurangzeb's successors had given up his policy of destroying the Maratha power. So the Marathas adopted a new policy. Instead of fighting with the Mughal power, they decided to protect it and expand their own empire in that role. They believed that restoring an old temple is as good as building a new one. So maybe Aurangzeb has died, but after Aurangzeb, whoever were the successors, okay, they also had in their mind, the only aim was there, their policy was there to destroy the Maratha power. So with that aim, they started framing their policy, but even Marathas thought that why should we be behind? Even Marathas started framing a new policy. They adopted a new policy. Now, what was the new policy? Marathas thought that they will not have a battle or a fight with the Mughal power. Instead of fighting with the Mughal power, they thought that they will protect their power. The Marathas decided that we will not fight with the Mughal powers. Instead, we will protect it and expand our Maratha rule in place of Mughal rule. So that was the new policy adopted by our Marathas, that instead of fighting, we will expand our Maratha rule in place of Mughal rule. So they believed, and from which thing they got this inspiration? This inspiration was derived by our Marathas from an example that it is good to restore an old temple instead of destroying it. Okay, so instead of building a new one, or for building a new one, we need to destroy the old temple fully and then build a new one, yes or no? So they thought that why to destroy and why to build a new one? Instead of that, whatever is the old temple, restore it, renew it. So same inspiration, same policy was adopted by them. While they have adopted a new policy with the Mughals, okay? The Mughal power faced the threat of the Irani and Afghani invaders from the northwest and also of the local Pathan, local Rajput, Jat and Rohila rulers. Now, that time, Mughals had, they were facing the threat or endanger or risk, okay? They were facing the threat of which people? Irani and Afghani invaders. Invaders means what? The people who are coming and looting, okay, our country, they are called as invaders. So these Mughals at that time were having the threat or danger from these Irani and Afghani invaders from the northwest, and also there were another enemies in the local place. They were Pathan, Rajput, Jat and Rohila rulers. All these people from all these people, Mughals had the risk, okay? So then what happened? The internal competition and tussle in the court had also weakened the Mughal power. So that time, so many enemies of the Mughal power. So this has really weakened their power because there was a tussle competition, a very great competition in the court and internal competition. All these factors had affected, had weakened their power. Whose power? Mughal power. And due to all these, the Delhi court needed the help of the Marathas. Now, as the Mughal power was weakening and there was a threat of so many enemies to the Mughal power, that power was weakening, and that's why Delhi court, they needed help. But from whom? From the powerful Marathas. Because that time, Mughals were having less power and Marathas were having high power. Then Balaji Vishwanath. After Sahu Maharaj was released by the Mughals, turn your page, he made Balaji Vishwanath a Peshwa. Balaji hailed from Srivardhan in Konkan. He was competent and experienced. He convinced many Sardars that Sahu Maharaj was the real heir of the Maratha Empire and made them join hands with him. Now, Balaji Vishwanath, he was a very excellent person and a very, cunning person, you can say. After Sahu Maharaj was released by who? Azam Shah, yes or no? By the Mughals, then this Sahu Maharaj, he made Balaji Vishwanath as a Peshwa. He declared made Balaji Vishwanath as the Peshwa of the kingdom. And this Balaji Vishwanath had come from which place? From Srivardhan in Konkan. He was really a very competitive person and he was very good in experience also. That's why by his experience and by his competency, he convinced many Sardars from the, many Sardars. He made them convinced. He changed those Sardars and took them in our side, that is in our Sahu Maharaj side. And how did he convince the people or the Sardars? By saying that Sahu Maharaj is really a real hero, means he has inherited all the qualities, all the bravery, all the courage from his forefathers, that is his father Sambhaji, then his father Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, that is his grandfather. So he has inherited all this good qualities, all these qualities of bravery and courage from his forefathers. So he is also same like his father and his grandfather. So you should join hands with our Sahu Maharaj, as he is a great, he is a great Maratha empire. So this way he convinced people by saying good things about Sahu Maharaj. Then Kanoji Angre was the chief of Maratha Navy. He chose to side with Maharani Tarabai and attack the territories of Sahu Maharaj. Now what happened? As Balaji Vishwanath was appointed by whom? Sahu Maharaj. And he was working for whom? Sahu Maharaj. Same way, Maharani Tarabai has appointed Kanoji Angre as the chief of the Maratha Navy. Okay. And he was working with the on whose side? On Maharani Tarabai's side. Remember, Maharani Tarabai and Sahu Maharaj had opposition. They were having conflicts between them. Okay. And that's why on the saying of Maharani Tarabai, Kanoji Angre, he started attacking the territories of Sahu Maharaj. Then this gave rise to a difficult situation. Yes or no? Now this Kanoji Angre, he was going on attacking our Sahu Maharaj's territory. So this created a very bad situation that time. And then what happened? Sahu Maharaj, in reply to him, sent Balaji to fight against Kanoji Angre. But our clever Balaji, what he did? He avoided the war and won Kanoji over to Sahu Maharaj's side. Yes or no? Is it interesting? Kanoji Angre was on whose side? On Maharani Tarabai's side. But now, after some time, as Balaji Vishwanath was sent by Sahu Maharaj to fight with him, then Balaji Vishwanath, he was a very cunning person. He did not have a war. He avoided the war war with Kanoji Angre. In fact, he turned Kanoji Angre towards our Sahu Maharaj's side. So that way, Sahu Maharaj was a really, Balaji Vishwanath was really a influential person, and he influenced many Sardars and even Kanoji Angre, the opposite enemy party, towards our Sahu Maharaj's side. So that was the great work done by our Balaji Vishwanath. Then I will continue in the next video.